In this video, we're investigating the convergence of the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity of natural log n over n quantity squared. And we're given this weird hint of, well, you should do a comparison to this series, 1 over n to the 3 halves. And most of this video is going to be spent trying to motivate why we would even think to compare to something like that. And so when I look at this, my first thought is, well, this is kind of like 1 over n squared, but I have a natural log in the numerator, and that's growing as n becomes large. So maybe this thing is not converging as aggressively as 1 over n squared. I'm going to compare it to 1 over n, and that is the divergent harmonic series. So we're going to do a limit comparison here and see what happens. Okay, so those are the terms of the series that we're working on, and then we divide by the terms of the series we're limit comparing to. That's the same as multiplying by the reciprocal, and I can clean things up a little bit. I get natural log of n all squared divided by n squared, but one of those is going to cancel with the one in the numerator, so I end up with a divided by n. Okay, that's like an infinity over infinity indeterminate form. So we're going to use L'Hopital's rule for this, and I want to be careful not to say that L'Hopital's rule applies to a discrete sequence that's being evaluated at integer values of n. So I'm going to instead look at the limit as x goes to infinity, natural log x all squared over x. And we know that if the limit of a function of real numbers settles down to some value, then the same is true for the discrete sequence corresponding to those integer values of x. So I use L'Hopital's rule once, and I get 2 natural log of x times the derivative of natural log of x. There's the chain rule in action. And then the denominator is 1. And I'll rewrite this real quick as the limit as x goes to infinity, 2 natural log x over x. That's also an infinity over infinity indeterminate form. So I've got to go again. And I end up with a 2 times derivative of natural log of x. That's 1 over x over 1. Which gives me a 2 over x, and the limit as x goes to infinity, which is going to go to 0. Now, unfortunately, we can't conclude anything from this because we took the ratio of the terms of our series to the terms in a divergent sequence, and we found out in the large n limit that goes to 0. This is essentially saying that the terms in our series are smaller than the terms in a divergent series. That doesn't tell us anything because being smaller than infinity doesn't necessarily mean it's a finite result. So this is an inconclusive limit comparison test. The next thought that occurs to me is maybe we should compare to something that's converging a little more aggressively. And the natural choice for that is to compare to the convergent P series, 1 over n squared. So let's give that a try. When I divide by 1 over n squared, that gives n squared over 1. And out of this one, the n squareds are going to cancel, and I just get the limit as n goes to infinity of natural log n all squared, which clearly goes to infinity. And so I've just shown that my terms are essentially bigger than the terms of a convergent series. That's another way of being inconclusive. Being larger than a convergence series doesn't show divergence or convergence. All right, and then I think to myself, and this is where the motivation finally comes in for the hints. I compared to the divergent harmonic series. I compared to a series that was converging more aggressively to that. In each case, I got these inconclusive results for kind of opposite reasons. Why don't we try a power of n that's just right in between those two? So that's the motivation. And I set up the limit comparison. Again, dividing by 1 over n to the 3 halves is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal. And I have an n squared in the denominator, n to the 3 halves in the numerator, which is going to leave me with a square root of n in the denominator. And that's an infinity over infinity indeterminate form. So again, I'm going to talk about a function of the real numbers in terms of x's now, just because that makes it so I'm allowed to use differential calculus. And so I'm going to re-express the thing in terms of x. Then I'm going to take the derivative of the top and bottom, again, using L'Hopital's rule. The square root of x is x to the 1 half, so that differentiates to 1 half x to the negative 1 half, which is the same as saying 1 over 2 root x. All right, I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal there, and I get the limit as x goes to infinity of 4 natural log of x. And then when I multiply root x times 1 over x, that gives me 1 over square root of x. So I'm just going to throw that in the denominator in the same step. And that's an infinity over infinity in determinate form. So I have to differentiate again using L'Hopital's rule. It gives me 4 over x in the numerator and again 1 over 2 root x in the denominator. And I multiply by the reciprocal of the denominator and I end up with 8 root x over x. All right, cancel that root x out of the numerator and end up with 8 over the square root of x as x goes to infinity, which is finally an unambiguous thing, and that gives me 0. And again, the result of the limit on the function of real numbers is going to be the same as the result of the limit on the function of integers over here. So we know that one over n to the 3/2 is a convergent P series because P is bigger than 1. And we just showed basically that the terms in our sequence are substantially less than the terms in this convergent P series in the large n limit. So in this case, we can conclude now that our series actually converges.